Cycle Boy UK here again. I'm going to take a step back from the Transformers again for this video. It's kind of stuff that will go along with my kind of movie memorabilia and just memorabilia in general. For the people from the UK that watch my videos, you'll know of the story HMV. For those that don't, for those that stay in the States and elsewhere that don't have HMV, it's a store that sells DVDs, music, CDs, things like that, games, books, and all kinds of stuff to do with bands and stuff like that. Whole load of different kind of things they sell. And they've got a really cool loyalty scheme where you build up points on your card. You can go to one of their sites and pick prizes out of a list of thousands usually. And there's always different things, movie tickets, concert tickets, personalised gold discs, things like that. And just over the last kind of year or so, I've been getting stuff from it. And I got an email off them about 4 or 5 days ago saying that I had an amount of points and they were about to run out and expire. So I thought, well, I better go on and use them. So over the last kind of 2 years, I've built up somewhere in the region of about 40,000 points. And it's going to sound crazy, but unlike most kind of normal people that go for like the concert tickets, movie tickets, because I collect kind of movie memorabilia and memorabilia in general, I thought, well, why not go for something that I can enjoy and I can look at, you know? So that's what I've done. So that's basically all these different things are from memorabilia, things that I like, things that I may not like, but I thought looked cool and stuff like that. So the first two items I'm going to show you were got when I originally had my iPhone 3GS. I was looking for covers at the time, and these covers were on this site, and I thought, well, I'm looking for a couple of covers, so I may as well get these. They cost me about, I think it was about 900 points each, maybe more, maybe less, but they're iPhone 3GS covers, one for Avatar, and one from Street Fighter, which is, I think, the E-Honda face paint. Again, I got these both when I had my iPhone 3GS, but then it broke about 6 weeks later, so I've never really used them. So they're now just part of my collection, just novelty kind of stuff, really, which is really cool. I do have a set that came in with that. It's of Transformers stickers, but they've kind of taken a wander and they've disappeared. I know they're about somewhere, I just need to find them. But I did get Transformers stickers with them as well. The next two items I'm going to show you, I'm not going to go into too much detail with these. I will post a blog later today just with pictures of the items and a quick description of each item on the blog. But these are 6 or 7 glossy postcards from different world cinema movies, and they've all got kind of quotes from the films and images from the films in them as well. So I'll give you a better look at those on the blog post later on, because I don't want to be running into kind of like 10 minute territory on YouTube. The next item, again, it's postcards again, but again, these are from the movie Black Swan, and the postcards are done in the kind of 1920s, kind of 1930s style of poster, which looks really cool. It's one of the reasons why I got them, really, because they looked kind of really cool, and I thought, well, if I can have these, then I can frame them and put them up, because they look really cool. They'll never get used as postcards, but they'll get framed and shown off, because again, they look really cool and it's the novelty of having them. The next four items, again, these will be framed. Again, these are very high quality pictures, 10x8 images of different bands and singers, two of which I know of and the other one I've never heard of in my life, so it could be a foreign band. I would like some help and information on the last one. The first one is it Alphabeat. It's a still taken from a concert that they done in the past, I assume, or in the recent past anyway. But again, it's a very high quality picture, as you can see. This camera will do it no justice. There are another three of these. If I can just find someone to put this without ruining it. The next one is Athlete. Again, that's a band that I have heard of, same with Ultrabeat. That's obviously an image taken during a concert. It looks really cool. These will all be framed up and put into a frame, and they'll be hung up on my wall at some point in the not too distant future. These next two images are of the same, I assume it's a group, called Delphic, I don't know how to pronounce it, but it's spelled D-E-L-P-H-I-C, so I pronounce it as Delphic, but I could be completely wrong. Any information on this group would be awesome, so if you give me any information on this, it'd be great. I got this picture purely because of the fact that it looked really, really cool. It looks as if they're underwater, kind of breathing up, and they've got bubbles coming across their face and stuff like that. I thought that looked really cool, and that's one of the reasons why I got that picture, because it looked really, really cool. And the next picture, again, it's the same group. It's just a few more guys in the picture. But yeah. So if anybody can help me out with this group, if they can link me to any of their songs or any of their stuff, I'd be greatly appreciated, because I would like to hear some of their stuff, of that group in particular. The next four items now are A3 sized posters from a series HMV do called My Inspiration, and it's actors, authors, musicians, different people from different industries that HMV sell and deal with. And these four I've just gotten over the last year and a half, but two of them I got in today from the latest hauler stuff that I got through my points. So the first one I'm going to show you came in the first set of stuff that I got about 6-8 months ago. It's a picture of Daniel Craig. A lot of you will know him as James Bond, but more recently he was in The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo, in the Hollywood remake of that movie. I haven't actually seen it myself, so I wouldn't know if it's a great film or not, but I do like Daniel Craig in the James Bond films. He suits the role really well. He's got his wee inspirational message there. Miss Jean Louise, stand up, your father is passing, from To Kill a Mockingbird. And just in the bottom, is it right hand corner or left hand, depending on how you look at it, it's got its limited edition number there, 169 of 500. There's only 500 of these printed, and I have one of them. The only downside to these is you can only get one of each My Inspiration poster, obviously for obvious reasons, so you're not getting like two or three to sell them. But again, this is one that I do like. It's of somebody I like and I admire for what they do in the industry that they're part of. This next one, forgive the fanboy squee, this is a god to me as far as gaming goes, and I know he's a god to a lot of other people gaming wise as well. It's one of the reasons why I got it. But again, it's Hideo Kojima. Again, he's a game designer, for those that don't know. He's designed some of the greatest games in gaming history. Metal Gear Solid, Zone of the Enders, Castlevania, just to name three. But he has been part of other games as well, mainly Metal Gear Solid. Again, he's a wee inspirational message there. Surrender to self-preservation from others who care for themselves. A blindness that touches, perfection that hurts, like anything else. Isolation, isolation, isolation. And it's from a Joy Division song, I think. And I assume again, it's a numbered limited edition. Things are 369 of 1,000. Again, same rule applies. You can only get one of each of these, which is really annoying, because I'd love to get more of them just to be able to sell them. Another thing I'd like to do with that, or I'd like to have done with that Hideo Kojima one, is gotten down to London when he was in London recently for the 25th anniversary of Metal Gear and gotten it signed. It would have made it even more rare and even more awesome. This next one, this is from the latest haul I got. This is John Hurt, a British actor. A lot of you might know him, a lot of you might not, but I know him from the TV series Merlin. He plays the voice of a dragon in that. The inspirational message there is, the truth is rarely pure and never simple, which is actually a really cool inspirational quote. And again, just the number at the bottom there, it's 514 out of 1,000. So these are all limited numbered editions. This next one, I teased one of my friends about on Twitter. I really shouldn't have done. I do feel kind of bad about it, but they're a bigger fan of this person than I am. I am a fan of this next person, probably less than the person that I was teasing on Twitter. I do apologise for that. But again, it's a limited edition. It is, I think that's a one. It's 110 out of 1,000. Again, so it's a limited edition. and it's of Lady Gaga. So for the ones that are Lady Gaga fans, feel free to hate. I don't know what to do with this one yet. I am a fan of Lady Gaga, as is my partner. These will most likely be framed and put up on the wall somewhere. But again, just in the bottom corner there so you can see it. 110 of 1,000. These will all be, there will be pictures taken of these and will be put up on my Blogspot, a link to which will be in the description below along with my Facebook and my Twitter. That stuff there. It's just stuff I've accumulated over the last year through this scheme that HMV do. So usual, if you enjoyed the video, comment, rate, subscribe, and I'll see you again in my next video. Thanks for watching and see you later.